Shri Chinmay Satgurave Namah. Om Shri Guru Bhyo Namah. Om Sahana Bhavatu
Sahana Bhunaktu Sarviryam Karvavahai Tejasvinavadhi Tamastu Ma Vipishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Samasta jana kalyane niratam varnamanam
namami chinmayam deham sadgurum brahma vidvaram.
Hariom, salutations to all. Whatever we want to achieve in our life, whether it is success, whether it is harmony in relationships, happiness, for everything there is one very important requirement, and that is our mind must be calm. If the mind is disturbed, anything that we do, performance will be not up to the standard. Whether you want to be successful as a student, as a businessman, as a professional, in any sphere of life, quietude of the mind is a very important aspect. So meditation is, let me ask you one thing, is it a verb or is it a noun? The word meditation.
Verb.
Noun. How many say it is a verb? How many say it's a noun? There only two categories of it. You can't not have a choice. It's not an adjective or a verb. So meditation is a state. So it's a noun. People say, I am doing meditation. It's like saying, I am doing waking. Are you doing waking? Or are you in the waking state? Those who are, they are answering. Rest of them are not in the waking state. Meditation is a state of mind which is quiet. And at a deeper level, meditation is a state which is beyond mind also. That we will see as we go along. So first step is to understand what is our mind. All of us have a mind? Confirm? Brought it with you? So mind each of us has. Gurudev is to define our mind as what? Mind is a flow of thoughts, like the river is a flow of water. Continuously the water flows, then there is a sense of a river. Stagnant water, we don't call it as a river. In the same way, thoughts flow continuously in our mind from the time we wake up. In fact, the reason for us to wake up is our thoughts. We wake up because we think. From deep sleep, we come out of that state because of thoughts. And from that time, continuously the thoughts keep passing through our mind, full time. So just like the flow of the river, there are three important aspects. How do we determine the quality of the river? The quality of the water determines the quality of the river. If the water is clean, the river is clean. If the water is muddy, the river is muddy. If our thoughts are pure, then the mind is
pure.
If the thoughts are positive, mind is positive. If the thoughts are negative,
mind is negative.
And if the mind is negative, that means the person is negative. So we are what our mind is. At the moment, we don't have any other identity. As the mind is, so the person is. So as the mind, so the man. As the man, so the world. So first and foremost in meditation, what it helps us to do is to transform the quality of thoughts and make it positive. How? When we think about the positive, when we think about great ideals, when we think about the Lord, automatically we imbibe all those qualities. Whatever we think about, we bring about. So what meditation helps us to do is to transform the negative into the positive. And what is already positive, it will make it more positive and stronger. Because you see, the important point is, if we have to face life successfully, will always circumstances be conducive to us? Most of the time they may not. We thought that 5 o'clock in the morning it will be bright. Sun decided otherwise. That's the natural rhythm of the sun. We mistook it. Summer when we come is very bright. 5 o'clock and all is absolutely bright. We expect something, but something else only happens. So situations can be anything in life. What we have the choice is not in that. How we face in that, we have the choice. So great achievers, if you see their life, they would have achieved great things, not because everything was favorable, but in spite of things being not favorable also. How are they able to do that? Because they can keep their mind positive. So first thing that meditation, the objective of meditation is, mind must become positive. Second, the river is a mighty river or a thin river based on what? The quantity of the water that flows. Millions and millions of gallons of water is flowing down the stream. Then that river is a huge, mighty river. Brahmaputra, Gangaji, so many huge rivers. You know, one of our most ancient rivers, based on which our culture is, on the banks of which our culture grew and developed. Do you know the name of the river? Saraswati River. Sindhu is different. Saraswati is different. They are in the same region. So our culture is actually the Vedic culture, which is called Saraswati Sindhu civilization. Indus Valley is a remnant of that civilization. Earliest civilization is Saraswati Sindhu civilization. Do you know the width of that river in some places? It starts from Kapal Shikhar near Mansarovar and comes down to Haryana, Himachal, Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, Gujarat, goes into the Arabian Sea. That's the route of Saraswati River. Just imagine, what would be the width of that river? In some places, the width of that river was 20 kilometers. 20 kilometers. Just the width. Huge. So, the quality of the river is determined by quality of the water. The force of that river is determined by
speed of water.
The speed, the quantity of water. Same way, if our mind, the flow of our thoughts continuously, when we say, the quantity of that of the thoughts. But the difference is, in the case of a river, the mind, the river which flows, which has more quantity, is more powerful. But in the case of the mind, the more the number of thoughts are, do you feel powerful or weak? We get stressed, no? To come here, did you have stress? No? Early morning, you have to wake up, get ready. Pata nahi hai, Swami ji log sote nahi, humko sunne nahi dete. Mind may have been stressed. And mind goes on thinking. In a day, how many thoughts do we think? Many thoughts, yes. Any idea? 64,000. No?
Much more. 60,000.
You calculate. per second one thought, suppose you do. In 1 minute, how many seconds?
60
seconds. 60 thoughts in 1 minute. Just average. 60 thoughts in 1 minute. If you want to have, that itself is huge. Calculate like that. 60 minutes, how many? 3600, not 360. 3600 is for 1 hour. Into?
24.
No, 24. You are sleeping, waking hours. Waking hours. Suppose you sleep for, let us say, 8 hours. 3600 into 16 hours. Karun. Somebody calculate it. 36 into 16 you have to do. 16 is 96.
57,600.
So average human being thinks 60,000 thoughts. And every thought takes away energy. So we get stressed out today's life. You ask somebody, how are you? Generally they say fine. But if they know you well, stressed, tensed, worried, anxious. 12-year-old fellow, you know, on WhatsApp group is saying life sucks. 12-year-old guy. What have you seen in life? Yeah? But that's how life has become. Stressful, boring, difficult. Why? Because the mind is not in control. So quantity of thoughts has to change, has to reduce. The lesser the thoughts are, the more powerful that mind is. Because the same thought, if you sustain, is what will manifest into action. You all kept that in the mind, no? That we have to come here, sustain that thought. So you are here. If we sustain the thought, it will manifest. A person who becomes a teacher or a doctor or anything, you know, artist, musician, because they sustain the thought. The mind which is fickle has to be trained to be focused, single-pointed. Concentration increases when the quantity of thoughts reduces. So quality must become positive. Quantity must become lesser and more focused. And the important third point is direction. The direction of the thoughts is generally outside. We are more aware of the things outside. Escaping from our own mind. In meditation, we pay attention to our own mind. The direction is internal. We are trying to withdraw the attention from outside systematically and focus on our thoughts. And so step by step, that process of withdrawal is what we have to do. From the world outside to the body, from the body to the breath, from the breath to the mind, and focus the mind. And then finally go beyond the mind also. That's the whole science. So this is a process whereby we learn to purify the mind. There's this formula called PUT. P-U-T. If you put your mind through this, success. In the world outside, in the spiritual realm, both. P for purify the mind. U for unify the mind. And T for transcend the mind. What is P for? Purify means make it more positive. U for? Unify. Make it focused, single pointed. And T for? Transcend. So in the next few days, this is what we are going to achieve. P, U and T. So today we will learn first three steps. First step is the preparation and posture. That we have to sit. How should we sit? Like an exclamation mark, not like a question mark. Sit erect, straight. Why? Because when you sit erect, the mind is alert. Also, the energies that are generated in the body will travel properly in the gross body, in our mind. So the head, the neck, and the spine must be in a straight line. The eyes are closed, what you can do, Janak, switch off some of these lights. Keep that on. Okay, sit erect. Close your eyes gently. Relax your shoulders. If you are sitting on the chair, let both your feet be firmly on the ground. They should not be hanging. Let your hands be in your lap, palms facing the sky. If you like, you can keep your hands on your knees. The palms must be facing the sky. Bend your index finger to touch the tip of the thumb. And let the other three fingers be straight. Come to a comfortable posture without any strain in any part of the body. Invoke gratitude in your heart. Thank the Lord for all the blessings that we have. To be able to meditate in the Himalayas itself is a great blessing. We have a healthy body, good family, good upbringing, so many blessings we have. Genuinely thank the Lord for all the blessings as well as all the challenges, because they help us to grow. Know that the grace of the Lord and the blessings of the whole Guru Parampara are with us as we embark on this journey. Meditation is a state where the mind is positive, the mind is peaceful. By the grace of the Lord and the blessings of the Guru Parampara, may we be successful in our attempt to quieten the mind. So this is the first step, physical preparation as well as the mental attitude. Second step is auto-suggestion. Mentally tell yourself, for the next 10 minutes, I am steady and still without any movement. With all your willpower, tell your own self, I am steady and still without any movement. I am alert, awake, and quiet is the second auto-suggestion. I am alert, awake, and quiet. Generally, our mind, when it becomes quiet, we go to sleep. So we have to tell the mind that I am alert, awake, and yet I am quiet. A still body is very important for a still mind. Hence, make no movements for the next 10 minutes. Just sit steady and still without any movement. Third auto suggestion, I am a spiritual seeker. At this moment, I don't have any other roles to play. I'm trying to make my mind calm and quiet. I am a spiritual seeker. Third step, present moment awareness. Be aware of the simple happenings around you. Bring your mind away from the past and the future into the present moment. And just be aware of every simple happening around you, moment by moment. The silence around, the various sounds, the chillness in the atmosphere. Just be aware. As you hear any sound, just be aware, don't judge. Non-judgmental awareness is what we have to abide by. Just be aware of the sound, the silence, and whatever else happening around you. Fourth step, relaxation of the body. As I suggest the part of the body, mentally pay attention to that part of the body. When I say inhale, take a deep breath. And when I say relax, exhale slowly. And let that part of the body relax completely. Be aware of your left leg from the thighs to the toes. Be aware of your thigh, the knee, the calf muscle, the ankle, and the toe of the left leg. Inhale, take a deep breath. Relax. Exhale slowly. Inhale. Relax. Inhale. Same way, relax the right leg from the thighs to the toes. When we visualize the part of the body and pay attention to that part, the energy that we take in through deep breath goes to relax that part of the body. So visualize the right leg, the thigh, the knee, the calf muscles, the ankle, and the toe. Inhale. Relax the trunk. Be aware of the neck, the chest, the stomach, the navel. All the vital organs are in the trunk of the body. Inhale. Relax. As you inhale, feel that the lungs are filled with the air, how the chest and the stomach expand. And as you exhale, see how they contract. Inhale. Relax. Inhale. Relax. Inhale. Relax. Relax your back from the neck to the base. Visualize the whole spinal column. If you are not erect, come back to the erect posture. Visualize your upper back, the middle, the lower back. Take a deep breath. Relax your left hand from the shoulder to the fingers. Be aware of your left hand fully. Inhale. Relax your right hand from the shoulder to the fingers. Relax your face, the head, the back of the head. Take a deep breath. Have a gentle smile on your face. Let your breathing be slow, steady and deep. Thank the Lord for a healthy body and the ability to sit quietly for some time. Be aware of your body. Be aware of the happenings around you. We pray for the well-being of the whole universe. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah. Sarve Santu Niramayaha.
Sarve
Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu. Kashchit Dukha Bhag Bhave. Asato Ma Sadgamaya.
Asato Ma Sadgamaya.
Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya.
Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya.
Mrityor Ma Amritam Gamaya.
Mrityor Ma Amritam Gamaya.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Hari Om.
Rub your palms. Place them on the face and gently open the eyes.